Ibrahim Dogus, who walks out there. There he is. There he is. The owner of Troy Restaurant and founder of the Center for Turkey Studies. So please join me in welcoming Ibrahim, who I personally like to call the King of Kebab, to the stage. Here he is, the man, the legend.
Thank you. My name is Ibrahim Dogus, and I'm the founder of British Kebab Awards. Welcome to the 6th annual awards, bigger than ever before. In 6 short years, our event has grown into a major part of the culinary calendar. It is our chance to celebrate our industry, recognize the superstar chefs, the energetic entrepreneurs, and to remember all the people working hard on the high street, or on a delivery bike, working as kitchen porters, or waiters, or in a kebab van, often late at night. Our industry includes Kurds, Turks, Greeks, Lebanese, Armenians, plus many, many other communities, some old, some new. Many of these communities come from places of violence, repression, and war. Where tensions between peoples divide, our love of food unites. An event like this, just like a business, doesn't become established. Without real hard work. So I want to start by thanking our supporters, and especially our sponsor Just Eat, and Just Eat's Managing Director Graham Corfield and Marketing Director Ben Carter. Graham and Just Eat have been a friend of British Kebab Awards since day one. Graham, you do understand our industry. You get the importance of kebab to local culture and jobs, and we sincerely thank you for your continuous support. Someone else who has been a great supporter since the start of these awards is Lord Bilimoria and Cobra Bill. Karan Bilimoria is such an inspiration to everyone starting and running a business. He knows what it is like to start a business at the kitchen table, to take the knockbacks and disappointments, and to build something really special and successful. He is a great public servant and member of the House of Lords. Thank you, Karan. Some more people to thank. Mustafa Topkaya, Önder Şahan, Timur Ekingen, and Altan Kemal. They were the first people I told about the idea of starting these awards. And Mr. Şahan was the sponsor of the first British Kebab Awards. Samson Soheil, Ravi Ranger, and Shani Gupta are a few other great people on whom you can always rely. Without their encouragement and support, we could not have done this. They have also been unconditional supporters of the work we do at the Center for Turkey Studies, CEFTUS, and British Kebab Awards. So, thank you. And I must mention that tonight, we are partnering with Sarcoma UK, the cancer charity, and are raising money for them this evening. Please be generous. Later tonight, we'll see who has won our coveted awards from over 5,000 nominations across the country. That's the most nominations ever. So thank you to our judges in their very difficult task of choosing the best of the best. We have so many people, so many special people here tonight, as well as chefs, owners, waiters, suppliers, and the other people who make the magic of kebabs happen night after night. We are joined by some of the people enjoying them. Members of Parliament, Lord Commons, and House of Lords from all political parties, welcome. And from the world of newspapers, radio and television. Tonight, we have representatives from the Financial Times. Are they Randi? Are they in now? Financial Times? There. The Sun newspaper, Daily Mirror, Daily Mail, Daily Telegraph, Mail on Sunday, New Statesman, The Times, Al Jazeera, ITN, Spectator, Independent Evening Standard, and London Life. You may have seen us on Saturday Kitchen or heard us on Chris Evans' show on BBC Radio 2. We also have our friends from the trade unions who are supporting local jobs and local communities. Francis O'Grady is here from the TUC. We have Len McCluskey and Steve Turner from United Union. Friends from GMB. Friends from Diamond Miners Association. Mick Wheeler of Aslan. Manuel of TSSA. And our friends from RMT and many, many other unions with us this evening. Thank you very much for your solidarity, both here in the UK, and your support on international issues too. Thanks to the team at SEFTUS, and I am very proud to say that SEFTUS is now a London Living Wage accredited employer. Long list to thank, and there's one person I thank every year above all, and this year she deserves extra thanks, and that's my lovely wife, and our wonderful son, Mirza. This year we opened a new restaurant, the Westminster Kitchen, and I spent a chunk of summer 2017 as a parliamentary candidate, so it's been busier than ever. Tonight, we celebrate the people with the love of good food. The visionaries who build a business. The creative geniuses who deliver hot meals in the most difficult of environments. We recognize the contribution of immigrants to our national life. Kurds, Turks, Cypriots, Lebanese, Armenians, and others besides. Some have been here for generations. Others are still getting used to the cold and rain. But the fact is that without people leaving their homes and starting a new life in the UK, our culture and society would be poorer in every respect. Show our solidarity with minority communities and with immigrants. So, a special plea to all politicians and the journalists in the room. Let's celebrate the people who come here from across the globe and help to build a better Britain. Jobs. We add to the colour and vibrancy of our towns and cities. So let's celebrate, not denigrate, immigrants and their families. As we head towards Brexit, our economy will need more startups, more independent businesses, more SMEs, and the kebab industry, alongside many other in catering industry, is a massive net contributor to the economy. Brexit must not be allowed to leave a damaging legacy to our catering industry and to small and medium enterprises. That is not a price worth paying. We have launched a new initiative since last year, the British Takeaway Campaign. I am proud to be the first chair of the British Takeaway Campaign, an industry-wide group that champions the economic, social, and cultural contributions of the takeaway sector. The takeaway sector contributes around 9.4 billion to the UK economy each year. That's 0.5% of economic growth and employs 231,000 people across the UK. Our mission is simple, is to ensure its continued growth. That's why we are working hard to ensure takeaways, not just kebab shops, but also curry houses, fish and chip shops, Chinese takeaways, and pizza places can access the skills they need from within the EU and beyond, and through developing high-quality vocational training. Thanks to Just Eat, who have shown a great leadership and genuine interest in supporting their partners within the takeaway industry. Tonight, we are joined this evening by members of the British Takeaway Campaign, including our friends from the Bangladeshi Caterers Association, BCA, the Food Packaging Association, the Italian Restaurants, Federation of Fish Buyers, Singapore, and many others. I hope you too will give the British Takeaway Campaign your support. I have another announcement to make. Last year, we launched Bira, world's first beer for kebabs, thanks to Cobra Beer. Without their help, this would not have been possible either. This year, we are launching the National Kebab Week. So you have a whole week to enjoy kebabs now. This week, the week that has 14th February, the Valentine's Day, will be the National Kebab Week from now on. Another great chance to highlight what we do. So tonight, we celebrate the kebab and its place in our popular culture and local economy. Think about this, over 20,000 kebab shops. The perfect end to a long evening or a daytime treat when you're hard at work. The perfect combination of spice, color, texture, and flavor at a price every Briton can afford. A welcoming light on an otherwise darkened street